So I'm here at Arnie's gym with super featherweight prospect Kofi Yates. Kofi, it's 2-0 now. How has it started, your career out? Are you happy with it?
Started great, yeah. My first one, I was a bit nervous and all that, so it didn't really go my way. And then I've got the win and everything, good enough to win. Second one, just show me boxing ability, just boxed out boxing. And then third one's coming up now. Now I'm just a lot fitter, a lot stronger. So getting used to the pro training. So start knocking people out now, I reckon.
When is your third fight then?
20th of July at the Reebok.
9 points to 30.
Being a professional fighter, you've had a bit of time to bed in. You know, is it the life you wanted? You know, you really enjoying it?
Yeah, probably enjoying it now. Like I was running a security company with like my friend and stuff. But now just I give up everything, just become a boxer. So I don't do no doors, no nothing. I just work.
It's dedicated to the life now.
Dedicated to the boxing, yeah.
You work with Arnie over here. Great gym, isn't it? Great teammates, to great sparring, everything like that. So
that's it. Yeah, there's a few at my weight here. So, well, not my weight, but around my weight. You've got Joe Murray. John Murray's here now as well. So, I've not sparred John yet, but hopefully we'll get some sparring done. We've got Matty Fagan, he's an unbeaten prospect himself. Yeah. Paul Butler, he's a big hitter for his weight and that, you know, big talent. So it's just full of bubbles in the gym, you know what I mean?
And you're from Wythenshawe, South Manchester. You have a great following from the area, and the last couple of fights at the Forum, you know, you've brought masses with you, haven't you? So
it's been like, we've been on Jimmy's undercard, or Jimmy Kelly, so it's like, this fight's breaking away from that. I'm on my own now, you know what I mean? So see, we're taking fans away. So I sell like 140 tickets for my first fight. I've done about 100 for my second. But now everyone's interested, you know, now we're moving away from home and stuff. So hopefully I just can't see who comes on the road with us now.
Well, I look forward to seeing the rest, Kofi. You know, you're definitely a sort of fans' favourite style and everything. And, you know, I can only see good things ahead for you, mate.
Yeah, mate. 2 years, top title contention in 2 years.
British title.
That's
the dream, isn't it? A Lonsdale belt, you'd love that, wouldn't you?
Yeah, mate, I'd love to win a Lonsdale belt, alright.
What British rivals, finally, you know, who do you see on the scene, who, you know, you could be chasing in the next year or two?
Well, I don't really see anyone that I'd chase. I'd rather just build myself up, and then hopefully everyone would have to fight me, you know what I mean? I'd like you say, bring good following, good crowd and stuff like that. So by the time I'm up there in the 2 years, the money fights will be with me, hopefully. So everyone chases. I was like, I won't say I'd call anyone out, but like Anthony Crawley's my good friend. He's the stone for everyone at the moment, and he's like the cash cow for everyone. That's the way I see it anyway. Mm-hmm. Everyone wants to fight him, so hopefully that'll be me soon.
You wouldn't fight Anthony, would you?
No, would he? Yeah. I'd fight him or Joe. Good friends.
There's a couple of good fights coming up as well domestically. If you know the Frankie, Gavin, Denton, Vassell. Belting fight. You know, how do you see that one going, mate?
I get on with Frankie and I get on with Denton. I was at a meal with Denton the other day, like, but the way I see it, if Denton catches him, it could be a lights out for Gavin. And if he's got to catch him, Frankie's known for his boxing ability. And to be fair, I'd say Gavin. I'd put my money on Gavin because he's just his superior boxing skill. But Denton don't know how to lose. You know what I mean? I don't think he's lost one fight since he's even started boxing. So. To be fair, I would be sat there neutral. I can't pick
a winner myself, but
I won't like to pick. To be fair,
it's certainly all the sort of fights, British boxing and boxing needs making, don't they? They're the matchups that we want and keep the sport alive. Really.
Tyson Haye,
that's my next one. I mean, you know Tyson personally, you grew up with him, didn't you? So, you know, that's another one,
you'd
but a great fight.
It's a 70-30 fight for Haye, wouldn't you? Really, if you had to put your house in it, the same, but. I think Tyson's another one that don't know how to lose. He don't take it well, you know what I mean? So, when he fought Cunningham, he changed his style and he won the fight. I think he can do the same with Haye. Not fought anyone Haye really, has he? If you look back at his record, there's no names really. Come against Klitschko, couldn't get past the jab, did nothing. So,
I think one of the sort of things you're saying, you know, if Haye does catch Tyson like he did Cunningham, he's a great finisher.
He's a bigger hitter than Cunningham as well, I'd say. So if Tyson will be working on that overhand right, because he's been put down with it a few times, so that could be the factor of the fight. That overhand right could be all over in seconds, but Tyson gets up, like you see David Price, and he got caught with that shot, and that he got up and it recovered. Well, Tyson gets up, he recovers, doesn't he? So it's just, we'll wait and see. It's another one where you can't pick, but $5 million each, so it don't matter who wins or loses. He's 23 years old, he's going to win a world title sooner or later.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the other thing, maybe we've seen the best of A, we haven't seen the best of Fury yet.
Nah, 23 years old, you know what I mean? You can't, something else.
Yeah. But great to speak to you again, Kofi, always is, mate, and catch up again soon.
Cheers.